Sometimes, not often enough, we reflect upon the good things, and those thoughts always center around those we love. And I think about those people who mean so much to me, and for so many years have made me so very happy. And I count the times I have forgotten to say thank you, and just how much I love
pounds. Oh, very nice build. He had green eyes and a cleft chin.
What were you, walking backwards?
I happen to have an excellent memory. So, what do you think?
Well, I think you should forget the whole thing altogether.
I mean about the coat. Look how she doesn't even notice.
Oh, Lucille, it's just beautiful. New?
Have you seen it on this gorgeous body before?
Well, I think you should wear it in the best of health.
Guess what the best part of this is? Guess how much?
Oh, a coat like that? Oh, you must have paid at least 3,000.
No.
Less?
Much.
Oh, what? 2,500?
Nope.
Don't tell me it was less than 2,000.
1,950.
Oh, but what? I'm fainting.
Is that a steal?
Yes. So, where did you find it?
Well, I was in Manhattan walking down 57th Street when I came across the Ritz thrift store. Now, normally, I'd never even look in the window. I mean, what could they have? Garbage, right? This time, I look in the window, and guess what I see?
That coat.
No, a full-length brown fox that would make your heart stop. So I go in, I try it on, and my muzzle's a little too, short. So as I'm walking out, I happen to look, and what do you think catches my eye?
That coat?
No, a leopard jacket that would make your heart sing. So, but for as much as I get to wear it, it just didn't pay.
You know, we're not getting any younger here, Lucille. Where'd you find the mink?
Oh, well, as I'm on my way out, leaving, I happen to see them bringing in a whole new rack of clothes. So I happen to look down. Guess what catches my eye?
Who knows?
This coat!
Oh, thank God!
But there's only one thing that bothers me.
What?
Well, did it belong to someone else? I mean, who knows who this woman was? All I do know is that she was tall, terrifically slim, and probably did not look as good, half as good in it as I do.
Well, what are you worried? You got a gorgeous coat at a great price.
But I know, why would she give this coat up?
Who knows? Maybe she died.
Oy vey. I never thought. The poor woman, she could be dead. The poor thing could have died in this coat. She could have been wearing this coat, crossing the street, got hit by a car. Oh, are there any marks on it?
No, it's perfect. There's not a scratch on So, what do you think?
Does the name Lana Turner mean anything?
Oh, let me see.
What becomes a legend most?
Oh, stop!
You know, maybe tomorrow I'll go back and I'll look and see if we have a second one that I can get for you. Picture it, you and I out on the town fur from head to toe.
Eh, it's not me.
All the more reason.
I don't need it.
Ida, you don't buy a mink because you need it. You buy support hose because you need it. You buy a mink because you want it.
I don't want it. Besides, I couldn't afford it. Where did you get $2,000?
Oh, one of Harry's municipal bonds came due.
Well, congratulations. Would you like some tea?
Oh, I'd love it.
I'll go put up the water.
Oh, good. You know, I broke a pretty heavy date just to come here today.
Oh, who you got now?
Oh, his name is Donald. Ida, if I tell you.
Good looking?
Oh, he's gorgeous. And a gentleman. He opens the door, he pulls out the chair. He picks up the check. We had a Friday night like you would not believe. We went dinner, dancing, a handsome cab ride through Central Park.
Oh, so romantic.
Oh, and he didn't leave me alone all night, hands everywhere.
No.
Oh, yes.
So, when do I meet him?
Oh, you'll meet him.
You never stay with one long enough for me to meet him.
Tell you what, if I'm still with him next week, I'll bring him by for canasta. So when am I going to start hearing about you? A little romance, a little excitement.
When it happens, you'll hear about it.
Well, Ida, I'm all ready to start double dating. And I just can't keep taking out both men at one time. I'm serious, Ida. I'm waiting for you to join me. God knows Doris is never going to.
Oh, I wonder where she is. It's after 11. I thought that she would be here early. Today is a very important day for her.
Oh, it's always an important day for her. It's the highlight of her month. If she plans it for 2 weeks before and then she thinks about it for 2 weeks afterwards, it's like a vicious cycle.
Well, sometimes a cycle is important. It lets you know what to expect.
Well, my cycle ended more years ago than I care to remember, and I'm still going strong.
I just hope that today goes well for her. Oh, I can't believe that it's already the fourth anniversary.
Today is her fourth anniversary?
Yes.
Oh, I totally forgot.
Lucille, how could you?
Well, I can't keep these dates all straight anymore.
You really should try.
You know, sometimes I think we should just stop this business altogether.
Oh, Lucille.
I do.
Yeah, I don't know myself anymore.
You see?
Okay, well then why do you keep coming?
Well, don't think I haven't asked myself.
I'm serious.
Well, the truth is, I kind of like this time together. But there's more important things we could be doing on an afternoon.
Well, whatever you do, don't bring it up today.
I won't say a word. Whatever she wants to talk, we'll talk.
You're a good friend.
The best.
Where have you been?
Oh, fine, thank you. How are you?
We've been worried sick here.
Oh, I overslept.
Today?
I haven't been sleeping too good. Did either of you get another bill from Perpetual Care?
You mean other than the one in the spring?
Yeah.
No.
Oh.
I haven't paid the one from the spring yet. I figure when Blue Cross sends me money for Harry being sick, I'll pay the cemetery for Harry being dead.
Well, I can't tell you how much it's gone up, and you'll probably get yours on Monday.
Again, it's gone up?
I know.
And what are they going to do if we don't pay? What, are they going to move them?
I'm going to go see if the tea is ready.
Okay. So how are you, Lucille?
Good. You look different.
Oh, I dropped a couple pounds.
Oh, you're losing weight.
Oh, I wish. It's just moving lower. So what do you think of this day?
Oh, it's nice.
Nice? Oh, and what beautiful day hasn't been invented. The leaves are just starting to fall and the colors are gorgeous. Abe's plot is going to look terrific. Oh.
I'm sure it will.
I just hope they kept up the care. You know, that argument I had with them last month. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. They say they're watering twice a week while I'm looking down at that ivy.
Oh, I'm sure it'll look terrific.
You know, fall was Abe's favorite time of the year. A wonderful man taken much too soon.
Oh, I know. Who would believe 4 years ago today? You remember? Of course I remember. Oh, it was almost exactly a year before my Harry died.
That's Murray.
What's Murray?
Murray, I was Murray. He died a year before your Harry.
Murray died the year before Harry?
Of course, and Abe died 2 years after Murray.
So Harry died 3 years after Abe?
That's what I'm trying to tell you.
So who died the year before Murray?
No one.
Are you sure?
Yes, I'm sure. Abe died 4 years ago today.
That's what I said. 4 years ago today, a wonderful man taken much too soon. Who could forget?
You know, they were all wonderful men.
Yeah.
I wonder what the three of them are doing now.
Probably trying to find a fourth to play cards.
Probably, right?
So, what are we talking?
We were just discussing what the boys would be doing right now.
Murray's easy. Right now, he's sitting, smoking a cigar. In any minute, an ash is going to fall and burn a small hole in a cloud.
Well, Harry, let's see, it's Sunday. So Harry will go right for the Manhattan real estate section, and then he's going to, thank you, yell for a half an hour how 25 years ago he could have bought a brownstone on Park Avenue for $30,000.
Oh, Abe is walking. Sundays were his day for walking. So wherever they look up there, that's where he is.
Well, here's to the boys, wherever they are. To the boys.
You know, I was reading about this woman who can contact the dead. Like, she says she can talk to them, and you sit in a circle and hold hands around a big table. I think it's called a seance.
Nah, it's a seance.
A seance, that's it. Well, she actually can contact them. You put something that belonged to the deceased on the table, like maybe the picture.
Nah, I don't believe in that.
I don't know. I've heard some pretty interesting things.
I think I'm going to try it one day. I mean, just imagine if I could contact Abe. If I could only talk to him for a few moments.
I don't know if I would want to contact Murray.
Why not?
Because it's unnatural. Your husband dies, that's it. The time for talking is over.
Unnatural is a man dying in his prime. You get married with someone that you love so you can spend the rest of your lives together.
You get married till death do you part.
If I could contact Murray, I would like to ask him what he would have done. If I had gone first, I wonder if he would remarry.
Abe never.
I don't know. I think Murray would. What about Harry? Do you think he would?
No, I could care less. The only thing I'd like to ask Harry is if there's a baseball somewhere he forgot to tell me about. I mean, what difference would it make if he would remarry or not?
Oh, that reminds me. I cannot believe that I almost forgot. I spoke to Selma this morning.
Oh, don't tell me.
She's getting married.
Oh, at her age?
Well, it just goes to show you that you're never too old.
She's too old.
Well, she's the same age I am.
I rest my case.
You want to start talking age? After all, next bunch of...
No. Oh, don't you dare.
It's like watching my two older sisters fight.
Oh, please, you just stay out of this. You're only 3 days younger than dirt.
Yeah. And the who's talking? I was with you when you celebrated your 50th birthday for the fourth time.
I did no such thing.
Oh, yes, you did.
I am very proud of my age. I happen to think that I look pretty terrific.
I do too. I just hope I look as good as you when I reach your age.
Oh, please! You did!
I hope I reach your age.
You have. Twice.
And you've been your age as long as I've known
you. All right. Why don't we just call it a tie on this one?
All right, honey.
So where was I?
Selma's
getting married. Oh, yes. So I told her that we would all be there.
Of course.
We have never missed one of Selma's weddings.
Well, that's what I figured.
And she wants us to be bridesmaids.
You're kidding.
I didn't know her that well.
What happened to the woman she used the last time?
Well, she doesn't like to use the same bridesmaids for more than one wedding. She says it's bad luck. Listen, why don't the two of you come over here? We'll get changed and we'll all go together.
Why not?
Sure.
So when's the affair?
Month after next.
So soon. Why didn't she just meet Arnold over the summer?
Oh, she's not marrying Arnold. She's marrying Ed.
Who's Ed?
A guy she met a couple of weeks ago on a singles weekend. She says they are madly in love. And are you ready for this? His name is Ed Bonfigliano.
Bonfigliano?
That is not a Jewish name.
Oh, he is not a Jewish man.
Okay, so what happened to Arnold?
He died.
So Selma's marrying an Italian?
Go figure.
Well, she never did like being alone. Selma always said that she felt so lonely living in that house all by herself.
Listen, if you're feeling lonely, you get a dog, not an Italian.
Maybe she's got the right idea. Don't you think?
Yeah, I think that, I think she has the right idea.
Now, what are you talking? The woman goes through nylons like I go, the woman goes through husbands like I go through nylons.
Oh, please, look who's talking.
Dating is one thing, marriage is something completely different.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to agree here.
So when are you going to start?
Oh, don't you push it. Listen, I think we should be going. I do not want to be late.
What? If you're a little late, what? You leave?
Sorry. It's cold out?
It's a little chilly.
It's perfect. The cemetery is going to look gorgeous. And if Abe's Ivy is dead, heads are going to roll.
It'll be fine, I'm sure.
So, Taurus. Just a minute, let me show you.
Wow.
So, what do you think?
It is gorgeous.
Go ahead, guess how much.
Oh, well, for something like that, I'm sure you got it second hand and you paid a good price with a little haggling. Like you paid $1,900.
We'd love to.
See you later.
Oh, I think think she's handling it very well.
Oh, much better than last year.
Oh, you remember how we had to carry her out?
One minute she was fine, the next minute she's laying belly up on her cloth next to Abe's, yelling, take me now.
Well, I think she's over that now.
I hope so.
I'm gonna go over to Murray's.
I give you my regards.
Perpetual care, my foot. Perpetual negligence is what it is. Look at how I can't even see the dates. Hank, if I didn't come here every month, you'd be lying under a jungle. You know, when I trim the ivy like this, it reminds me how I used to cut your hair in the kitchen. Do you remember? Little off the top, a little off the back. Don't go clear to the front. Don't make my part too wide.
Doris was right. It's just beautiful. We couldn't have picked a nicer spot. Funny when I'm here with you, knowing Doris is with Ava and Lucille's with Harry. It's just like old times. Reminds me of the cruises that the six of us used to take. You, Harry, and Abe would gamble while the three of us shot from one end of St. Thomas to the other.
So, Harry, read any good books lately? I guess I'll have to do all the talking. Nice, just like when we were married. Only now, at least I know where you are every night.
Sometimes it worries me, Murray, the memories being that strong. Oh, it makes it so hard to... I don't know.
Let's see, what has happened since we last spoke? Selma is getting married again.
I just want you to know, Harry, things could have changed. All we needed was just a little time. But no, you had to be in a hurry about everything. You couldn't even go into remission like a normal man. No, everything you had to do quick.
Sometimes I look at Lucille and wonder if maybe she doesn't have the right idea. I'm not saying that I want to go out and start having flings. Lucille, I am not. But it just doesn't seem right to close myself off anymore.
Just a little time. That's all we needed.
You are never gonna guess who's chasing the women. Max Goldberg. Can you believe that? At 76 years old, he started chasing the girls. You know, I asked his wife, what was she going to do about it? You know what she told me? Well, he's 76 years old. Who cares if he's chasing women? Dogs chase cars, but when they catch them, they can't drive.
The thing is, Maurice, I don't know if I could go out and start meeting people and also keep coming here to see you.
So, Harry, what do you think of the coat you bought me? Or what?
Oh, I forgot. I got a picture.
Oh, hello there.
Hello.
So you come here often? Just a little cemetery humor.
Just look at your grandson.
So your wife, she stays at home while you go to the cemetery?
My wife is who I come to visit.
Oh, how nice.
I probably should get going.
Oh, just give me a second. I'll walk with you.
I wonder what you're doing while I'm standing here talking. If you're up there, listening, smoking a cigar.
Sometimes I see David playing with the toy in the living room. Oh, with such concentration he sits.
How I used to yell at you for smoking in the bedroom. To this day, I can still smell it every once in a while.
Abe, he reminds me of you when you would sit for hours trying to fix some gadget. I can still picture you at your desk.
It's been over 2 years.
4 years.
And sometimes it seems like
you're still right there.
You're still right there. If next month I should come, Bowie, I'm not saying that I won't, but if I shouldn't come, promise me that you won't be upset.
One day I think I'll bring David.
You were a wonderful man, Bowie.
To talk to his grandfather.
Another one like you, I wouldn't find.
Oh, so help me, 1950 and no tax.
It's a very nice coat.
Come over here, there's somebody I'd like you to meet.
Ida?
Sam!
You two know each other.
Well, of course. Sam here's the best butcher in the whole world. How are you?
Oh, good, and you?
Good. Did you come to see Marna?
Yeah.
Oh. Doris is over at AIDS. Today is the 4th anniversary.
4 years.
You think it'd be okay if I go over?
Oh, I think she would love it.
So come, I'll walk you.
Oh, wait. I almost forgot.
How did I get this far?
I'll, see ya when I see.
I got a pain right here, Abe, and it hasn't gone away in 4 years. There's so many things I miss.
Oh, hurry, she's gonna lay down with me.
Don't do it, Doris, don't lay down.
Do what? Who's lying?
I was bending over to pick up a stone.
Oh, you're scaring me half to death. Oh, hello, Sam.
Hello, Doris.
It's good to see you.
I came to pay my debt.
It's been 4 years ago today.
Ida told me.
Well, I'd like to just stand in silence for a moment to think and remember and hopefully get my heart rate back.
We're right here with you, Doris.
Oh, it's nice to have such good friends. You've got the best.
Maybe I should go.
Oh, don't be silly. So, what are you doing later on? So, why don't you join me?
Lucille!
Maybe you and I could.
I don't believe you.
What? I'm just trying to make Sam here feel comfortable.
Oh, well, stop flirting. He'll feel comfortable.
Lucille, really?
Well, what? How much longer are we going to have to stand here?
I am sorry to inconvenience you, but I would just like a few moments of silence to remember my husband who died 4 years ago today.
Maybe I should go.
No, it's not you, Sam.
Listen, if you want to pick up men, you go do it at another plot.
So what am I standing here for? What, just because your husband died 4 years ago today, I have to take this kind of abuse? Happy anniversary.
Lucille.
I really don't want to cause any kind of...
It's not you.
This whole deck is ruined.
Doris.
Shut the hell.
I think I left some.
Doris!
Sorry.
thought you were gonna rest in peace.
Do you realize how much time we have spent in that cemetery?
let me ask you something. Don't you feel sometimes that you miss having a man around?
You are not listening to me.
But, Doris, don't you ever think that it might be nice to, you know, to have someone there? Someone new.
Someone living?
Oh. Ida, Abe and I gave each other our lives.
I know.
And I still give. And every month I go back to tell him and let him know.
Well, but getting married again, would it mean that you loved Abe any less? And you wouldn't marry someone now for the same reasons that you married Abe?
I wouldn't marry someone now, period. Case closed.
What are you in such a hurry to get married? The thing you need to be doing right now is to go out and play the field.
Oh, what field?
Oh, it's an expression. It means that you should stop dating other men.
Oh, it's a stupid expression and a stupid idea.
You?
Dating? I wouldn't even know what to do.
Oh, it's like riding a bicycle.
This whole conversation is ridiculous. I mean, really. Sam the Playboy Butcher shows up and the two of you go crazy.
Oh, come on, Doris.
I expect it from her, but you aren't shocked.
Oh, Doris, there is nothing to be shocked about. No one is going crazy. We're just talking here. And I would hardly call Sam a playboy.
Oh, well, what was he doing at the cemetery?
What do you mean, what was he doing at the cemetery? He was visiting Myrna.
Ha! He has not been to her grave in over a year.
Oh,
he only goes there to pick up women.
Don't be ridiculous.
Ridiculous? Don't you remember Rose Jacobs?
I remember Rose Jacobs. I don't remember them meeting at the cemetery.
Less than 5 feet from Mel's grave.
Oh, I like his style.
Stop.
And what about Sylvia Green?
You went out with Sylvia Green?
Am I lying? You know, it was only at Lou's unveiling, and he was there, and he caught her in the middle of her mourning, and then later that night went out for dinner.
Oh, I'm sure it didn't happen that fast.
Well, maybe my timing is a little off, but the place I remember, he got her at the cemetery.
Hello, Ida.
Hi, Sam.
Oh, hello, Lonnie.
It's Lucille.
Oh, I'm sorry. I got no memory for names. Oh, hello, Doris. I didn't realize you'd all be here. Maybe I should come back another time.
Oh, no, please. Come in.
Well, I remember the chicken livers you wanted, so I put some away on Friday, and I thought, well, since I'm in the neighborhood, I'd drop them off.
Well, that was really very nice.
Maybe I should leave it and go.
No, please, I was about ready to put on some tea. You'll have a cup.
So, a butcher that delivers. What more could a girl want?
I'm sorry about what happened at the cemetery. I shouldn't have been there.
Oh, don't be silly. It was nice to have a new face. Come sit.
I just feel like I ruined a very special moment between the three of you.
What's special? We go every month.
Every month?
I understand that you also enjoy going to the cemetery.
Sometimes I feel the need.
I'm sure you do.
So, what are we talking?
Oh, Sam and I were just discussing how sometimes one feels the need to go to the cemetery.
Oh,
so,
I see.
I think I have a great idea.
What's that?
Well, since Sam here goes to the same cemetery we are to visit his lovely wife,
Myrna.
Myrna, what say the four of us go together next month?
I thought that we decided not to go.
It's
supposed to be the three of us.
I just wanted...
Who put you in charge of the rule book?
Lord, I'm not sure when I want to go to the cemetery again, but I'm flattered you should ask.
Well, we may not be going next month.
You might not be going.
We were just discussing how it may be time to stop.
Yeah, we were just saying that, you know, there comes a time when you leave the cemetery and you go out and play the field.
What field?
I mean, there comes a time you have to stop going to the cemetery and start dating again. Before you came, we were just having a discussion about it, so,
I think you gotta do what's right for you. Well, for some people, dating might be out of the question. For others, it may be right. These cookies look delicious.
Oh, please help yourself.
And, which category do you fall into?
Lucille.
No, it's okay. I think it's time to move on. Sure, I go to the cemetery every once in a while when I feel the need, but I think I'm ready to start a new chapter. After all, what is life if not one chapter after another waiting to be written?
Oh, well put.
Sam, before you put your pen down, don't you think there comes a time when you stop? You maybe find some other things to enjoy and you sit back and read?
Like I say, you gotta do what's right for you.
Exactly. You know, some people are readers, others are writers. Now take me, I'm like you, I'm a writer.
I'm going to the bathroom.
You know, you haven't aged a day since I know you.
Sam!
You know, it's funny how time kind of passes some people by. You know, my friends say that I look younger now than I did 5 years ago. Why?
Why don't you go make the tea this time?
What, and leave Sam here all by himself?
Make the tea.
Fine, I'll make. But you two behave yourselves.
She's quite the woman.
Oh, you think so?
I mean different, not shy. Oh,
no, Lucille never knew from shy.
You know, it's strange. I get the feeling that I've met her before.
Oh, could be. She makes friends very easily. So, it was funny running into you today.
And of all places.
Go figure.
So, I guess Selma's getting married again.
Oh, yeah.
You going to the wedding?
Oh, of course. I wouldn't miss it for the whole world. And you?
Oh, yeah. Since I'm going to the wedding and you're going to the wedding, maybe you'd want to take one car. Maybe you could go with me. I could drive you there to Selma's wedding.
Sam, are you asking me to go?
I interrupted.
Oh, no, we were just discussing Selma's wedding.
Are you going?
Oh, I haven't decided.
Of course she's going.
Of course I'm going.
Tea time. So, what did I do?
We were just discussing Selma's wedding.
Oh, Mel?
Please, no sugar.
There you go. Well, I for one am looking forward. So are you going?
Yeah, I like Selma's weddings. They're like family reunions. Wait a minute. That's where I know you from. Weren't you at Selma's last wedding?
Oh, I've been to all of them.
How do you like that? All this time I didn't recognize them.
Oh, well, I looked much different back then. I was married.
Did you know her, Harry?
No.
Oh, he died about a year and a half before Lou Green's unveiling. Oh, you remember Lou Green's unveiling, don't you, Ida?
Yes, Doris.
How upset Sylvia was.
Doris.
How vulnerable.
Would anybody like another cookie?
I don't know how they can resist. They're delicious, wonderful. I haven't had cookies this good since I don't know when.
Oh, there's nothing to it. They're very easy to make.
Oh, for you.
Oh, if you like, I'll put some in the bag for you and you can take them home.
Oh, you don't have to.
Oh, no, it's my pleasure. I have plenty. I made to send to the children, but they haven't sent the tin back from the last time. So I'll put them in a bag and you can take them.
A tea? Maybe you could put some tea in a container.
Tea is about the only thing I can make.
So, is this a gorgeous day or what?
Oh, you know, I have a terrific idea. Being that it's such a beautiful day, why don't the four of us go out for a walk? In honor of Abe, you know, Sunday was his day for walking.
You talked me into it.
You know, why don't the two of you go? I've had enough fresh air for one day.
And I'll finish my tea, if you don't mind.
Of course.
I'm not such a mood anyway.
I think we'll stay. Why don't we play cards? You haven't seen either the Greek here play cards.
I am not in the mood for cards. You two go, it'll do you some good. And I'll talk to you tomorrow.
Our bags.
Oh. Excuse me.
You keep your bags under the couch.
Well, some people use the vault, but we've always used the couch.
It was good to meet you again.
Oh, same here.
Good to see you, Doris.
Yeah.
I hope I didn't cause any inconvenience.
Well, maybe we'll come back later.
No. You two go. Enjoy yourselves, and I will talk to you tomorrow.
Oh, we'll talk.
So, thank you for the livers. That was really very nice.
Oh, that was nothing.
So, how's business?
Oh, business is good.
Good.
I'm having a little trouble with the help, though.
Oh, no.
Yeah, it seems kids today, they don't want to work so hard. Not like when we were young.
Yeah.
As a matter of fact, I'm thinking about selling the shop altogether.
Oh, you're kidding.
The kids I hired today, they just seem to get younger and younger. The boy I've got now looks like he just got out of diapers.
Oh.
Then I think, people don't get younger. They're not getting younger.
No.
You have a beautiful home.
Thank you.
You play?
Oh, a little. The children, they took lessons when they were young.
That's quite the family.
Oh, well, you are looking at a woman who is five times a grandmother.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
I've got my first one on the way. Maybe you could give me some pointers.
Oh, well, that's the best part. You don't need any. You just enjoy your grandchildren, and then you sit back and you smile as you watch your grandchildren do everything to your children that your children did to you. Oh, that's a picture of Murray and me at the Concord, our 25th wedding anniversary.
Murray and I spent ours at Grossinger's.
Oh,
memories.
Nice to have such good memories.
What good? We were playing mixed doubles at the tennis court, and I had a heart attack at the neck.
Oh, simple.
My 25th anniversary present was a double bypass.
Oh.
At least it was something I could use. I never knew Murray as a smoker.
Oh, well, he didn't really smoke that much during the day, just, you know, mostly after dinner. Would you like some more tea?
Oh, sit. I'll get it.
What's so funny?
Oh, I was thinking about Sylvia Green. Doris made me think of her.
Well, what's funny about that?
Well, you probably know. It's a small neighborhood.
Know what?
We kind of went out on a date a while back.
Oh, really?
If you could call it that. It was really a fiasco. It all started at Lou's unveiling.
Oh, at the unveiling?
I know it sounds awful, but it was all because of my son, Richie. See, after Mona died, he didn't like the idea of me being on my own. So, he kept badgering me that I needed to find someone. I think what it was that he was afraid that if I didn't find someone to move in with me, I was going to move in with him. So he kept saying that I needed to find a friend. A friend is someone he calls the person that I should spend the rest of my life with. So after a few months, I thought, maybe I could find someone. So I started to go out, and each date was worse than the one before.
Oh, no.
Not that it was their fault, it was mine. Instead of looking at what a woman was like, I was looking at how unlike she was from Myrna.
Oh, not a fair thing to do.
No. So my last date was with Sylvia. We were going out for dinner, and I was determined we were going to have a good time. So I specifically picked a restaurant that Myrna and I had never been to. The Majestic over on Jewel Avenue. You know it?
The Majestic? Isn't that where Sylvia's husband had his heart attack?
That's the one.
Oh.
Who knew? So, we pull up in front of the restaurant, and she starts screaming, "Take me away from here! Take me away from here!" So, we drove around for about an hour, and that gave her enough time to calm down about Lou, but it gave me enough time to start thinking about Myrna. We decided that it was not the best time to continue our date. So, I home, apologized, and said goodnight. We never tried again. I think even without the fiasco, we knew we weren't right for each other. We talk every once in a while. She's a nice person, and a good friend. Don't let Richie know I said that. Anyways, I shouldn't have been going out so soon after Myrna died. It's funny how that when you lose someone close, someone that close, that you find yourself acting in ways you never thought possible, doing things you never dreamed imagining.
I used to cook. Like a mad woman. Day and night. I don't think that I left the kitchen for over a month after Murray passed away. I made meals that would put Julia Childs to shame. I forced dinners. Roasts, chickens, compotes, pies, you name it. Oh, Murray, he used to love my food. He always said that it was my dinners that brought him straight home from work every day. I don't know, I guess I thought if I kept making the dinners, he'd... I don't really cook that much anymore. I still bake every once in a while for the children.
Oh, you're close with them?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah. Would you like some more tea? Have you been going to the cemetery often lately?
No, not really.
So, what brought you there today?
This week would have been 40 years Myrna and I were married. I thought I should go.
So you didn't go to the cemetery for any other reason?
What other reason do you go to the cemetery?
Of course.
While I was there, I started thinking back over all those years.
They do go by.
One day you're on your knee proposing, The next day, you're standing next to a grave, remembering how nervous you were. And then somehow, 40 years passed between those 2 days. I better get going.
Oh, wait. I'll get a bag, and you'll take the cookies.
No, you don't have to.
It's my pleasure. So the affair will probably go late.
What affair?
At Selma's.
Oh, yeah, I guess.
I'll tell Lucille and Doris to go themselves.
You guys were all going together.
Well, we were, but if you and I...
No. I don't want to put them out.
I'm sure they won't mind.
I think it's best that you go with them.
Oh. Okay. Sure. I guess it doesn't really matter.
Well, thank you. It was good talking.
Yeah.
We'll have to do it again sometime.
Sure. I'll, see you when I see you.
Okay. Well, good night.
Good night.
Since Selma's wedding isn't for a while, maybe you would like to, I don't know, on a Friday, maybe go see a movie.
Sure, that would be wonderful.
And dinner. We could go see a movie and then have dinner. Or if you'd rather, we could go to dinner first and then see a movie. We could see dinner and have a movie.
Either way, it sounds good.
Okay.
Okay.
Well, good night.
Good night.
A lawsuit is what I should have. Police should pay me for all the work I do around here. Every month, the same thing.
5,000 places we could have met, and she picks the cemetery.
Oh, hello, Lucille.
Hello, Doris. So I just want you to know I'm only here today for this meeting.
I know.
Because I am through visiting Harry's grave.
I think you made that point very clear last month.
Long as it's clear. What do you think?
Nice!
Go ahead.
Oh, it matches your coat, too.
So guess how much?
Oh, well, something like that, you paid, you got it secondhand, and I'm sure you paid a good price with a little haggling. I'm gonna say you paid $200.
What do you do, follow me into the stores? I'm only here today because I'm concerned about Ida.
That's why I'm here.
No, it's not. You're here because this is your favorite vacation spot. I'm here because I don't want to see Ida settle for the first man that comes along.
Well, if she does, you only have yourself to blame.
Me?
Well, she's all you talk about not going to the cemetery. She sees the way you behave.
Well, better she should follow in my footsteps than in yours.
Have you talked to her lately?
No, I've been out a lot this past month.
Oh, you know, she's always gone. During the day, she's gone. At night, she's got an excuse why she can't get together. And I call her on the phone, and she seems like a different person. And it's almost like everything we shared is only in my mind.
So are you sure Sam's coming?
Yeah, I'm sure.
You told him the right place.
I told him.
And he said he would be here.
How many times are you gonna ask?
I just wanna make sure he's coming. You told him 4 o'clock?
No, I told him midnight. Meet us a week from tomorrow on top of the Empire State Building at midnight.
Well, it would have been better than here.
Do you know what you're gonna say?
What we talked about on the phone.
Here he comes.
Hello, Doris.
Hi, Sam.
Hello, Louise.
Lucille.
I'm sorry, Lucille. So, what did you want to talk about?
Tell him how you feel.
How I feel? What about you?
Well, you brought it up first.
Oh, 5 minutes ago you were on my side, now you're on his.
I'm not on anybody's side.
Thank you, Miss Switzerland.
What sides? What are we talking about?
What we feel, Lucille and I, is that you should stop doing something that you're doing.
I've done something to you?
Oh, not to me.
To you?
Well, no, but I haven't really given you the chance yet.
So who then?
To Ida.
To Ida? What could I have possibly done to Ida?
Sam, a woman's heart is it's a funny thing, am I right, Doris?
Yes, Lucille.
A woman's heart, well, it's a fragile thing. Right or wrong, Doris?
Right, Lucille.
A woman's heart is...
Lucille, it's gonna be dark soon.
Okay, Sam, after a woman loses her husband, her heart breaks. It breaks into many pieces. So she has to go out and she has to figure out how to put those pieces of her heart back together. But what she finds out in the process is that half of her heart is still gone. It's buried underneath a headstone with her husband's name on it. So she then has to go out and search for another side to her heart. And she does this by playing the field.
What?
What does this have to do with me?
What Lucille was trying to say in the worst way possible is that what's going on with you and Ida is no good.
What are you talking about?
What am I talking about? I'm talking about this whole past month.
Oh, we've been having a wonderful time. I took her to dinner, I've taken her to the movies, I even took her to a musical.
All I'm saying is that since you and Ida started, well, first of all, she and I have been coming here almost 3 years together every month, and now since you started this dating, she can't fix her husband.
She told me she just wanted to go to the cemetery less often.
Well, what do you think she could say? She's afraid and she feels tremendous guilt.
That's very true.
And on top of that, you're planning on taking her to Summer's wedding, where she'll have to face everyone who saw her last time with Murray. What do you think that's going to do to her?
And to you, Sam, you know, taking a woman to a wedding, it's no small matter.
But we have nothing to hide.
All I'm saying is that going to Summer's wedding together is wrong. I mean, God forbid it was you in the cemetery. Oh, God forbid, you should only live and be well. But suppose it was reversed. Do you think Myrna would be going to a wedding with another man, especially someone you both knew? Well, it not only defames the memory of Myrna and Murray, but it also shows no consideration for Ida.
She said this to you?
Oh, when you've been friends as long as we have, words aren't necessary.
We see it in her behavior.
She's confused and upset.
I don't want to do anything to upset her.
Then you should let her go to the wedding with the three of us, as the three, all by ourselves.
And then you can come and take all of us. Well, that way it won't seem so much like a date.
It's an awful lot to deal with. I mean, going to a wedding, being a bridesmaid, not having Murray there. It really is an awful lot to deal with, Sam.
I don't want to make things more difficult, Laura. So you know it better than I do. If you think that's the right way to go, then that's what we'll do.
I know you understand.
So we'll all go together.
Okay, then. I better get going. I'll see you in a couple weeks.
Yeah. And Sam, think about the whole thing, not just the wedding. You, Ida, Myrna, are you sure it's right?
So I think we did pretty good.
And you can come and take all of us!
Why not?
Because it wasn't necessary. You had to go with the play in the field thing again.
It's what she should be doing right now.
You're out of your mind, you know that?
Why? Because I don't think that she should be standing around polishing her husband's headstone for the rest of her life?
Twice. I polished Abe's headstone twice in 4 years.
You clean his headstone more than I clean my dining room table.
And now you know why we don't come to your husband in anymore. What, are we arguing then again? Oh, you know, the important thing is we put a end to this whole Sam business. So, you're going over to visit Harry while you're here?
Oh, what the hell, he did buy me the hat, and I'm so short to him.
Come on, I'll go with you.
All right.
I haven't said hello in a while.
You know, Harry always used to say that I have a half face.
Huh. On any other woman?
He'd say,
a hat is just a hat, but on you, it's the tops.
Abe wasn't a hat lover.
No?
No. Long, flowing hair. Remember how long my hair was?
Oh, sure.
Oh, boy, we were something, Lucille. You and your Paris hats, and me and the long red curls, and Ida and those clips.
Oh, those clips. Oh. We were quite the threesome, weren't we?
We were. We really were.
Come on. Let's go.
Him. Oh, I don't know. I'm
Maybe it's just me. Maybe I'm just not used to this whole thing.
Oh my, look how upset you're getting. Tell me now, is it worth it? Listen, tomorrow Sunday, we'll go to the cemetery. We'll forget about Senor. We'll go to lunch after my treat. What do you say?
Doris, you just don't understand.
Oh, hello, Lucille.
I like your hair. That looks good.
Thanks. I thought I'd try something a little different.
So where's Ida?
In the bedroom.
Hello, Ida.
Hello, Lucille.
So has she said anything about us going with her tomorrow?
No.
Oh, good. You know, I think it's going to be fun. We can all stay here to be like a slumber party.
Oh, well, I prefer to sleep in my own bed.
Why? What happens there?
Oh, I wouldn't expect you to understand.
What do you think?
Oops, good, huh? Wow! You made me a little nervous there.
It's wonderful that I was able to find something that matched my hat and my coat so perfectly.
Well, now we're going to need our mink shoes.
Yeah, okay. So, guess how much?
What's the difference?
Oh, go ahead and guess.
Oh. Well, for something like that, I'm sure you got a good deal, and second hand, and maybe a little highly, you probably paid what? $125.
$45?
You're kidding!
I got the receipt.
Why, that's some buy. Oh, it's not real.
What are you talking about?
Well, if you would have told me it wasn't real, I probably would have said about $45.
Well, it is real.
Well, I know mink. And real, when you pull on it, the fur comes out and that doesn't come out.
That's because it's well made.
Oh, I don't care how well made it is. It's not real.
Shh, don't say anything.
Hi.
Hi, Ida. So, what do you think of the mug?
Oh, Lucille, it's beautiful. Oh, it's nice. Soft. Ah, it's well made. If I didn't know any better, I would say that it was real. What's with her?
She thought it was real.
I did not think it was real. I'm gonna set up both of them. I was just testing you two.
So, I talked to Selma yesterday.
Oh, yeah?
She says this affair is gonna be the best one yet.
Wonderful. The affairs do get better every time. The marriages get worse, but the affairs get better.
Well, do you remember the second one?
Oh, what an affair that was.
Sure, the bakery guy.
Next time, from Nat's Notchery.
Oh, you remember that 8-course dinner? 7 of them were for dessert.
It took me 2 months to lose the weight I gained that night.
Tell me about it. I can't even look at a cannoli without getting sick to my stomach.
Well, we don't have to worry about that this time. This Ed fella, he's in the fruit business.
Fruit? Boy, I'm gonna have gas.
So she went from cakes to fruit? What kind of an advancement is that?
Could I use a little?
Of course.
What do you think? The green eyeshadow?
Sure.
You don't think it's too much?
Ah, you'll knock them dead.
Ugh. Dead? I got. You okay?
Yeah, oh, I'm fine. I just get a little pain once in a while. It shoots up my arm.
Oh, you know, I used to get it in the fingers in the mornings.
Yeah.
And I found that if I wear the copper bracelet, it helps.
Well, I tried that once. It didn't really seem to do much, but I did get a little better reception on my TV.
Harry used to get in bad all the time. You know, if the weatherman said it was going to be sunny and bright the next day, if Harry's hands hurt, I took an umbrella.
You know, we've not been to one of Selma's weddings without our husband. I hope she's paying by the head.
For every affair, there's fewer and fewer people. I wonder who will be missing from this one.
Hopefully some wives.
Oh, Lucille.
So what time is Sam coming to pick us up?
I don't know.
What do you mean you don't know?
Well, the last time we spoke, he said 5 o'clock, but I haven't really talked to him much lately, so he probably forgot.
You haven't spoken to him recently?
No, not for the last couple of weeks. He's been very tired from work.
And you haven't seen him either?
No, I don't know. I keep wondering if maybe I did something wrong the last time that we went out. Oh, we had such a wonderful night. Sam showed up at my door with flowers. When was the last time that somebody brought you flowers?
Abe's funeral.
You know, Harry used to come home with flowers all the time. That's how I knew he was cheating. The younger the woman, the bigger the bouquet. One time he brought home 2 dozen roses, and I said, okay, that's it. He's up for statutory rape.
Sam brought tulips. Yellow tulips. And they were just beautiful.
So why don't you call and make sure he's coming?
I don't think that I should.
Oh, then I'll call.
What if he doesn't call? I mean, if he doesn't call, we'll drive ourselves.
And why should we go unescorted? What's his number?
Lucille, I think it's a little forward to call.
You can never be too forward. Hello, operator. In Forest Hills, could I please have the number for a Samuel tax? Wants to know if it starts with a C. Starts with a K, ends with a Z. K-A-T-Z. A Jewish girl, she's not. Samuel, just like it sounds, starts with an S and goes straight to L. That's it. Okay, thank you and have a very safe trip back to Earth. Hello, Sam. It's me. Lucille. Fine, and how are you? Oh, glad to hear it. Okay, yeah, of course. Goodbye.
Well?
Oh, he was just leaving.
What? Now? Look what I look like.
We've got to get a move on.
Okay, well, I'm going to go upstairs and use your bedroom because I need all the space I can get. Wait till you see what I've put together.
I think she said she's wearing shoulder pads.
Under something? By themselves.
I don't know. She did say that, or that she doesn't have to wear the same dress that someone picked out.
Yeah. Well, I, for one, am a little nervous. This is the first time I've been to a wedding without Abe.
Oh, me too.
You know, there are going to be a lot of faces there. Familiar friends and couples.
You know, Murray used to love to make up stories about everybody there. Just for me, I mean. I would pick out a couple and then he would make up some funny story about how they met and how they argue. And I just used to laugh.
Yeah. Oh, Abe, he loved that dance floor. All night he could dance.
Me, you're telling? He called me up more than once.
You know, the cha-cha was our dance. He just loved that cha-cha-cha.
You going to dance?
Oh, me? I don't think I could.
Are you afraid?
Afraid of what?
Well, of dancing.
Well, no. I just don't think I'm gonna be in the mood, that's all.
Well, how could you know now if you're gonna be in the mood later to dance?
Oh, enough with the dancing. You love to dance. You still love it, don't you?
I do.
And you want to dance?
Well, if somebody asks.
And you want to dance with Sam?
If he asks. If my feet don't object, why should I?
But it wouldn't bother you that it wasn't Murray?
Doris, it can't be Murray. And what should I do? I'm standing, the music's playing, and Murray is not on the dance floor. You tell me, what should I do?
Go back to your table.
Doris, listen to me. It's enough for you to have your friends and your family and your children and to live alone, but me, I can't do it. I need to be with someone. I need to give to someone. That afternoon, after you and Lucille left, and it was just Sam and me here by ourselves, I came alive. I felt awkward and nervous and excited. My heart was pounding. For the first time since Murray died, I felt alive. And yes, I still feel miserable for feeling that good. But I am not going to give in. I am not going to spend the rest of my life feeling guilty for wanting to be touched, to be held by someone who isn't Murray.
You know, tomorrow is supposed to be a beautiful day, and I'm going to go to the cemetery, and I think I'm just going to have them take up all the ivy. Maybe put down some wood chips, because they last all year long, and then I don't have to worry if they're watering, and I think the wood chips will look nice.
I am not going to the cemetery tomorrow, Doris.
I didn't mention your name. I didn't say you were going.
Why don't you try just one time, not going to the cemetery?
Ida, you gotta do what's right for you, and I gotta do what's right for me.
Oh, my word!
Oh,
He's here!
Ida, there's something I need to tell you.
Where are my shoes?
Lucille and I did something.
Where are my shoes?
There, over there. Oh, but Ida, listen.
How do I look?
Oh, Ida, you look sensational. Yeah. But I gotta tell you something, Ida.
Oh, my jewelry. I don't have any of my jewelry.
Oh,
you get the door. I can't.
Ida.
Hello, Doris.
Hi, Sam. Mildred?
Hello, Doris.
Oh, I wasn't aware you were coming with us.
Well, I was supposed to go with George and Elaine, but Sam and I were having dinner last night, and I was telling him the only thing worse than going to a wedding alone is going as a third wheel. Well, Sam wasn't going with anyone either. I mean, he is driving you and Ida and Lucille, but he wasn't going with anyone. So he invited me to come along. How could I resist?
Of course.
She didn't want to go with George anyway.
Mm-hmm. It's nice to see you moving on to a new chapter so quickly.
I just hope those are your dance shoes you're wearing, because I have no intentions of letting you leave the dance floor. Hi, Ida.
Mildred?
Mildred's coming with us. Well, actually, she's going with Sam, but she's coming with us.
Hello, Anne.
Hello, Sam.
So, you girls are the bridesmaids this time?
Yeah.
I haven't been asked yet. Maybe our next wedding.
You look very nice. You both do.
Thank you. Maybe we should all come in and sit down.
So, I hear this Ed fella that Selma's marrying is loaded. Have either of you met him?
Oh, no. Not yet. It all happened rather quickly.
I know. First she was with Arnold, and then before anyone knew it, she was with Ed.
It really is amazing how quickly some people find replacements. What did you say?
So I haven't seen you for a while.
I've been busy.
Can you believe he's selling the butcher shop?
What? I didn't know.
Oh, I am sorry. Did you not want people to know?
It's no secret. I put it up for sale last week.
Why?
That's exactly what I said.
I think it's time.
What will you do?
I don't know.
Well, I can't imagine going anywhere else.
Oh, there's Irving's over on Queens Boulevard. He's got a great little shop.
Oh, it just won't be the same. Am I wrong?
I don't know what is taking Lucille so long. Lucille, are you ready?
I'm coming.
Sam is here, Lucille.
Oh, hi, Sam.
Hello, Lucille. So
you go. It wasn't anything important.
I was just going to say, I hope you don't run into too much traffic.
Yeah. Would anybody like something to drink?
Oh, no.
None for me, thanks.
Well, actually, I could use some water. Oh, you stay. I'll get it. Just point me in the right direction.
Glasses are above the sink.
Lucille, we're going to be late.
I'm coming.
Oh, I can never figure out how a woman who wears so little takes so long to get dressed.
Nope.
Diehl?
What are you doing here?
I'm going to the wedding. Sam?
Sam, being the gentleman that he is, offered to bring Mildred.
Oh, that was thoughtful. So are we picking anyone else up along the way?
I think the car is full.
It's a good thing you don't drive a bus.
Sam. Mildred.
It's a good thing that we had her along.
Why?
Who else would have told
talk.
You call that?
I don't know how anybody puts up with this.
Oh, sweet.
And has anyone ever seen someone dance the way she did?
No.
Forget it. I think she made a real spectacle of herself. Don't you think?
Yeah.
Don't you think she made a spectacle of herself? I mean, a real spectacle. But I guess some men like that kind of thing.
Well, then let's make a spectacle of ourselves, too. How about some music?
Oh, good idea. Let's see.
What?
I'll go look in the mirror to see what.
Says that Murray gave her his number and told her to have me call him. What nerve, I thought. So I called. I said, hello, this is Ida at Rivington 76207. You want to talk to me, you call me.
Good for you.
I hung up and I prayed. Sure enough, he called. And the rest, as they say, is history.
Oh, I remember the first time I saw A. I was working at my father's store behind the counter, and I could see him a couple aisles over, and between the shelving, I could see that he had on a pair of old pants and a big hole in the top of his right shoe. I thought, oh, this is not a boy for money. So I kept a little watch on him, you know, and all of a sudden he bent down, he grabbed a loaf of bread and he stuck it in his jacket. Oh, I didn't know what to do, so I ran over and I stood behind him and he stood up and our eyes met and all my heart started pounding. And I just didn't know what to do, so I screamed at the top of my lungs, crap, crap! And my father came out and grabbed him. And a month and a half later, we were married. My father used to say, this is my son-in-law, the crook. First he stole my bread, and then he stole my daughter.
That ever happened to you? Well, do you ever see Harry?
I didn't see that much of him when he was alive.
Well, but what about when you're with other men?
What do you mean?
You know, when you're in bed having sex with other men. Do you ever see him? You know, like picture him in your mind, I mean.
No.
Oh, come on. Not even once it didn't happen?
No. Who's having some more wine?
No, I don't believe you.
Why? Were you there?
Well, I don't even dance with somebody other than Abe.
All right. First of all, you couldn't do anything without thinking of Abe. And second of all, you're not me. So don't tell me what to think and don't think. Huh? Ada, you want some more wine?
I've had enough.
Of course you've had enough. You've had enough. You've always had enough. Everything's always enough. Don't go too far, don't have too much, just enough. Well, guess what? I've had enough, and I'm gonna have even more. You know, I think that when you die, you should be able to buy a great big coffin for you and your spouse. You should be able to lay next to him all the way until eternity. And then above my headstone is gonna say, here lies Lucille. She wanted more. And above yours is gonna say, here lies Doris and Ida. They had enough. And then after you lay side by side with your husband, you should be able to buy what, like a king size, a double at least. And you lay there, even if you don't talk, even if you don't touch, well, that's something. So, after I'm dead, are you guys going to visit me? I'm gonna be right in the neighborhood. I mean, just a headstone throw away. Get it? A headstone throw away. Will you?
Of course.
How about you?
Sure.
No, you're both lying. You're not gonna come and visit me. I'm just gonna be laying it all by myself because God knows where Harry's gonna be. So, you know, here we go back to my big coffin. I'll just lay there all by myself. But you know what? The whole time I'm laying there beside my husband, I'm gonna think and say to myself, you know, this just isn't right. This just isn't right. I'm done. I am at.
I still don't.
I'm going to bed.
Yeah, of course. Why, you had enough?
Yes.
Figures.
Let me tell you something, Lucille.
Oh, goody.
When you've had
there's nothing wrong, first of all, with having had enough. It just means that what you've had up until now has been good. And you don't have to run around making a fool of yourself trying to find more.
I'm making a fool? You sit at a dead husband's grave talking to him.
You leave Abe out of this.
Doris. Yeah, every month it's the same thing. Yak, yak, yak at Abe Silverman's grave.
Stop.
You know, for his sake, I hope he was buried with cotton in his ears.
Lucille!
Well, I do.
How dare you?
Don't get excited, Doris.
Lucille, you know why I go visit my husband every month? Because my husband deserves it. He was a wonderful man, and all our marriage meant something. In all the years we were married, he never cheated on me once.
Oh, come on.
Not once.
So help me.
Let me see.
He didn't have to cheat, because our marriage was good. So,
I'm warning you. Listen.
Don't you blame me, because your husband never loved you.
Oh my goodness.
Are you all right? Here, here's your water.
Enough! Oh my gosh! Enough! What is wrong with you two? Look at you! What has happened to us?
I'll tell you what's happened. You know, nothing means anything anymore. And this one here, she only wants to sleep around.
Oh, please.
And you have been making a fool of yourself chasing after Sam.
Oh, don't be ridiculous.
Ridiculous? You know, if we hadn't told him not to take you to Selma's wedding, you'd have marched in there and made a complete fool of yourself.
What did you say?
Well, you know, it really didn't take him very long to get over his loss.
And to think I had second thoughts.
You told him?
And you knew the whole time. You watched me get dressed. You watched me make up. And you knew the whole time that I was telling you everything that I was feeling and everything that I wanted. And you knew. And you watched me make a fool of myself when you walked in here with Mildred. And you knew. Both of you. I figured that you wouldn't understand, but I never thought that you would try to stop it.
We just wanted to.
What about what I wanted? Did you ever think for one second what I wanted? And who put the two of you in charge of my life?
We were only concerned with.
To hell with your concern! You weren't concerned with me! You were only concerned with yourselves! You couldn't stand the idea that I didn't want to go to the cemetery anymore. That maybe I wanted to do something else with my life. And you couldn't stand the fact that Sam was interested in me, and not you.
I can have any man wanted. I didn't want Sam.
Oh, please. I saw the way you flirted.
Come to the cemetery with us, Sam. Maybe you and I can get together, Sam.
No, I was just trying.
You were just trying to get him into bed.
No,
that's what you were trying. It's all you've done since Harry died.
I haven't been to bed with a man since Harry died. I just wanted everyone to know that I was fine. That I just didn't give a damn. I wanted them to know that they don't come any better than me. I don't care who he had, but if he was up there looking down, I wanted him to see me with a man. Or I wanted him to at least close his eyes like I had to for 3 years. I never said I slept with anyone. You only said I slept with them. I just never denied it.
Going to bed.
Ida, take whichever rooms you want. How about some more wine? A nightcap?
I've had enough. Because if you're not, I would really like to have a couple. And if you are, I'm going to go in the kitchen right now and cut my head off. thank you. I'm sorry. Do you want me to call Sam and make it all better? I'll explain.
It's a little late for that.
Ida, I'm sorry we interfered. We never should have. But you know, Doris and I saw you and Sam getting close, and well, maybe we panicked a little bit at the thought of our threesome breaking up.
Well, you certainly managed to stop that from happening.
Oh, Ida, don't hate me.
Stop. I'm not gonna hate you. I may not like you for a while, but I'm not gonna hate you. Help me clean up. Look what this place looks like.
Yeah, we'll tidy up. It'll be perfect. Oh.
Maybe we should use a little of that green eyeshadow and highlight the color in our cheeks.
Who's that?
I don't know. Here.
Maybe it's Selma coming over to tell us she's getting a divorce already.
I hope not. Oh, my word!
What?
It's Sam!
Oh!
Sam?
Hiya.
Hello, Sam.
Hi, Lucille. Where's Doris?
Oh, she's upstairs, probably still asleep. You know, we were in late from the wedding, and you know us girls, yeah.
Do you mind if I talk to Ida alone for a minute?
Oh, sure. I'll go make tea.
I'm not really sure what I came over here to say. I just knew I had to see you. Well, I guess what I really want to say is I don't want to stop seeing you.
You already did.
Well, only because I didn't realize that there was a possibility that maybe something was going to happen between us. Maybe that something was developing that
I wasn't ready for.
No, that I wasn't ready for. I think back, I was talking like such a big shot, ready to start a new chapter. Who was I kidding? I was terrified. I was just looking for a door to run out, and Doris and Lucille gave me one. They started talking about someone's wedding, and what it meant to take you, and I just...
So you took Mildred!
Well, not because I had any real feelings for her, but because I didn't. It felt safe. It wasn't a nice thing to do to you or to her.
No, it wasn't.
Ida, that afternoon I spent with you was one of the nicest afternoons I've had since Myrna died. And the evenings we went out, they felt wonderful. Each time I was with you, I thought about Myrna less and less. And that's what started to get to me. For the first time, I wasn't comparing somebody to Myrna. I was just enjoying you for being you. And that scared me.
I just want to know one thing. These last 2 weeks, did you miss me?
Oh, yeah. And you?
You were on my mind.
I lost one woman because there was nothing I could do to stop it. If there's anything I can do to hold on, what?
I think right now, somewhere, Marie and Myrna are having one hell of a laugh.
Oh, you think so?
Yeah.
Let's forget about the tea and let's go out and get something to eat.
Food?
and ice cream.
Ice cream.
I feel like a kid again.
Sure, we'll go for ice cream. We haven't eaten anything.
Nothing.
Oh, good. Well, go get dressed and get Doris up.
Yeah, go get Doris. I'm sure she's famous.
Oh, I'm sure.
Look, Sam. I want to apologize to you. We never should have gotten involved.
So where should we eat?
Oh, anywhere you want.
I know a great kosher Chinese place over on Linden Street.
Oh, Klein's!
No. You're thinking Klein's Korean Kitchen. That's over on Union Turnpike. I'm thinking Manny Peking.
Okay. But let me just get myself together a little bit. Because you know, no other man besides my Harry has ever seen me without makeup.
And you saw what that did to him?
I think you look better without it.
Thanks.
Is she up, Ida? Ida? Ida, is she up? Ida? Oh, Ida. Doris!
I'm here.
Doris!
I'm here.
Doris!
You coming?
No, you two go ahead. I think I'm going to stay here for a little bit.
Take care of yourself.
Tell him I said goodbye.